to Onyx Pages, or welcome back, as the case may be. I am in Orlando, Florida at the Carib Royale Hotel for BookNetFest 2018. For those of you who don't know, BookNetFest is a love fest of booktubers that was created by Mari from My Name is Marinas and Sam from Sam on Tomes, Thoughts on Tomes. And it's just a bunch of booktubers getting together and talking about books. And I've met some of my favorite booktubers here already, and I'm really excited about that. It's my first time in Florida, that's pretty cool. So I'm just kind of like relaxing, reading, and all that good stuff. And what am I reading? Where's the book? So let me tell you what I'm reading, because I'm super excited about it. I actually had planned to read Children of Blood and Bone by Tomi Adeyemi, and I actually brought it and haven't started it because I am currently reading Redemption in Indigo. And this is a really great book by Dr. Karen Lord. It is fantasy / magical realism. And Dr. Karen Lord, I believe that she's from Barbados. And I really like her work. I've read so far The Best of All Possible Worlds and now this. So I'm gonna actually find a spot to sit by the pool in my bathing suit, and I'm gonna read. Let me show you the pool. Hope you can see it. This is what the hotel looks like. And yeah, that's where I'm gonna go. I'm gonna go read a thing. Anyway, I hope that you enjoy this vlog. Bye.
I mean, I think it goes to that, you know, we're not all just one thing. And I think there is a recognition that writing books with diverse characters isn't about the diversity itself. It's about the people who have multiple, who are characters, and they're presented with identities that come through in the novel that shapes the experiences that they have and the interactions that they have with other characters. And so I think it's, I think we've all read a book, and I think we're getting better, authors and creators are getting better, but you've all read a book where it's like you have the token character, like the token person of color, the token, the gay best friend. It's let's move beyond tokenism, that's terrible. And intersectionality recognizes that people are complex and we have varying experiences and they all matter.
I think tokenism was part of my answer as well. It's just like, you know, yes, we need diverse books, and I think people are talking about that more and more, but there still seems to be this, like, especially I guess for people who are trying to publish, or, oh, but we have the diverse book on our docket kind of thing, or aren't you happy with this one example of like this thing that we already did? Like Angie Thomas has been on the New York Times bestseller list for like how many weeks now? And it's like, oh, yeah, 75 weeks now. Like, you know, aren't you like that kind of like mentality, spoken or unspoken, or even in like the microaggressive aggressions of like, isn't that enough? Or, and you're like, okay, that, you know, that's the tokenism coming in of like, but there's so much more to identity and there's so many other stories to explore. And I think that that's where intersectionality can really start to open the doors to those conversations of like, what does it mean to have, where these places where these stories are coming from, where identities meet. And I think the other thing is just in recognizing privilege. When we start talking about privilege in publishing and intersectionality, and just kind of that idea, you never want to take it to a place, and I don't know if you've seen this, where people are like doing like these marginalized like showdowns, where it's like, you know, well, I'm this, and you know, like you, but can we just listen to each other and talk about when rep is good and rep is bad, but also understand that intersectionality is not only like having one or more, but what it means at that intersection, like how those things interact. What does it mean for me not only to be a woman and a Latina, but a Latina woman? You know, like understanding the intricacies of of that, and understanding where my privilege is compared to somebody else, but also like kind of putting that all into perspective. And I don't think that we're quite there yet in some of these conversations, and it's just like, well, I'm this, so I can get away with it, or I get to say this, or I can get to do this, and we have to all like, hold on, like take a step back and kind of acknowledge our privileges in that aspect.
I just love Dan's reaction. He was just like, oh my god, what happened? This was such a cute story.
I'm not getting you in it.
Just kidding.
Just the table.
I decided to go to Universal Studios to the Wizarding World of Harry Potter. I am by myself and I am 4 years old. I will vlog as much as I can. So yeah. Okay, so I'm in the park and yeah, there's Diego.
We'll see you later.
Have fun on your adventure.
Diego's like, get out of here. Thanks. Okay, let me show you around.
Way there.
Oh, I thought you were part of it.
No,
very, very lovely. Have a good one. So I figure while I'm here, I might as well tell you about BookNetFest and how awesome it was. It was great. It exceeded my expectations. I primarily went because I wanted to have the opportunity to meet some really cool people, and I did. So I had a chance to hang out with Rachel Ray and Olivia from iLibby for Books. I hung out with Derby from Derby Lake. Forget the name of her channel, but she's so sweet. And from the Anne's Library. India from My Life as a Page Turner, and her boyfriend Eric. And just a lot of like really cool people, and I've of course Mari from My Name is Marines, and Sam from Thoughts on Tomes. So it was a really good experience. Yeah, I also finished Redemption in Indigo by Dr. Karen Lord, which I started a couple days before I left Toronto, which was also super fun. It was an amazing read. And I'm by myself now at Universal Studios, and I'm trying to figure out how to get to Hogwarts. They said something about keeping right. Let's see if I can. Hi. Excuse me. How do I get to Diagon Alley? Okay, thanks. So I've just been kind of like, I ditched my map and I decided that if I wanted to know where to go, I would just ask people. So I've made a few decisions about how I want to take care of my channel. One of the things that I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be changing the way that I rate my books. So I'm still going to be using the same 7 cowrie shell system, but I'm going to be changing a couple of the cowries because I realized that... Okay, so let me just finish off what I was saying. The way that I review books doesn't exactly match the system that I've been using, I realize. So for example, one of the cowries asks like, is this an Afrofuturist book? Which is an important question, but the thing is that I read all Afrofuturism, so I'm probably going to be giving a cowrie shell for all of the books that I read, so why not break that down a little bit? So. While sitting on the couch and chatting with Derby last night, I kind of created some changes to the system. So I will be talking about that in my vlog. Okay, so I'm gonna find Harry Potter Land. Bye.
I have a YouTube channel, yes.
You do?
I just got a new subscriber. Okay, so I found it. I don't know if you can see it, but there's the purple bus and King's Crossing of Hogwarts. And then there's that bus that they take. I don't remember which story it was in, but okay, so they have this thing where you can walk up to the purple bus, and I'm sweating. And the head talks to you in patois, so let's see what the head is gonna have to say to me. Hi, I'm vlogging, so.
You what?
I'm taking video.
A video?
Yes.
What's your name?
I'm in Jerry.
In Jerry?
Yeah.
It's nice to see you too.
Fucking head.
Hello.
How does that even work? I guess you can't really tell me.
I just open my mouth and I speak.
Okay. Well, it's good to meet you.
It's so nice meeting you, Jerry. No, that's a strange looking world she has.
Yeah.
Bye.
Bye, lovely. See you later.
All right. Oh, I just spoke to a shrunken head in fake patois. So that was great. Okay, let's go in. I don't think there's anything in here. Quidditch supplies. Oh my god, I'm gonna freak out. Get your food here.
All right, everyone, please call me back and thank you for selecting Ollivander.
Welcome to our banners. Makers of fine wands. It's 382 BC. What is your name?
Rachel.
And which is your wand arm, left or right?
Right.
So far. Now you may know that every Ollivander wand has a core of a powerful magical substance. Unicorn hairs, unique tail feathers, heartstrings of dragons. No two Ollivander wands are the same, just as no two unicorns, dragons, or phoenixes are quite the same. Of course, you will never get such good results with another wizard's wand. I think a hazel wand might do very well for you. This one is 12¾ inches long. It's a nice, flexible one with a dragon heartstring core. You can water the flowers for me. Point your wand and say Aguamenti.
Aguamenti?
That is not the wand.
Okay, so I got frozen butterbeer. So let's see how it tastes. Okay. So it's like a butterscotch drink. It's literally frozen. Sensitive teeth, so I have to like roll it around and melt it in my mouth, but it's good. It's like a sweet, sugary, like float with butterscotch.
train from Diagon Alley to, oh, I ran into everybody because I was by myself first. So we're taking the train to Hogsmeade, and apparently it's like a ride in itself when you see like all of these things. So that's about to happen.
Thank you.
Hi everyone, so my shuttle is late, but they apologize for the extended delay. Anyway, I just wanted to let you know that I'm leaving and I had a really great time. I hope that you enjoyed the vlog that I show you. I got some really cool footage. This is a little bit of Florida. My first time here is pretty cool, but really what was coolest was my experience at BookNetFest and all the great people I met, all the great experiences that I had, and of course reading Redemption and Indigo by Dr. Karen Lord, which I will review shortly. Okay everybody, bye.